The long wait is over, and the greatest sport in the world has returned. The NFL, baby. A sport so powerful that even people that say they won't watch it won't shut the fuck up about it. And what a first week. From the debut of Smokin' Joe Burrow to the mighty fall of the GOAT, week one of the NFL took everyone by surprise. Here's the facts. Week one of the batshit crazy 2020 NFL season. From the moment the Super Bowl ends, depression begins. What the hell are we supposed to do until September? We say it every year. This year, with COVID, the cut went even deeper. The apocalypse and quarantine took away even our side chick sports. But that's all over now. Week one started with a literal shit explosion, after the world was horrified to find out that one of the NFL's weirdest players enjoys being shit on from time to time. Fast forward a few days, and we have Houston against the Chiefs, featuring a still dominant Chiefs team against essentially just Deshaun Watson. Andy Reid was so pumped about the home opener, he grabbed the sneeze guard from the Golden Corral he was pregaming at and beelined it towards a game. The Chiefs absolutely rolled. No surprises there, though. Everyone knew this season was going to be weird, but no one was prepared for what Sunday had to offer. Right off the bat, during the 1 o'clock games, the NFL came out swinging. 5 of the scheduled 10 1 o'clock games were upsets, with 3 of those upsets being by Vegas dogs of 5 or more points. The Colts and their Tin Man quarterback, who breeds like a possum, shocked the world, falling to arguably the worst roster in the country. Gardner Minshew rolled the 8-point favorite Colts, porn mustache a-blowing in the Jacksonville wind. The Philadelphia Eagles got beat by a team so far in the dirt, they literally don't even have a team name. The only highlight from the Eagles during this game was that Carson Wentz didn't go out for the season. But there's always next week, baby. We believe in you and your bird bones, Carson. Make us proud next week. The 4 o'clock games featured a clash of the Titans. And by Titans, I mean 2 past their prime 90-year-old quarterbacks doing everything they could to not slow down the great rosters around them. Brady looked bad. Really, really bad. And went from Tampa darling to getting ripped on almost every Bucks group in existence because, you know, Tampa. It was fun while it lasted, Brady. Now welcome to the Thunderdome, bitch. Smokin' Joe Burrow showed us that no matter how much young talent someone possesses, in the end, playing for the Bengals is still playing for the Bengals. Despite a respectable fourth quarter ending drive by the young gunslinger, Joe quickly found out that his new Tiger team was more Joe Exotic than it was Woods. Sunday night, the Cowboys game gave us what we all crave, a shit performance by a shit franchise. While the game may have been stolen from them by an Academy Award-winning Ramsey performance, it was God's will for the Cowboys to fail, and fail they did. Happy trails, America's team. 8-8 awaits you. Monday night, a recently reformed and neutered Big Ben set out to defeat an improved Giants team who ultimately still sucks balls. We didn't know what we were going to see out of the Steelers great after giving up booze and porn in the offseason. But Cosby certainly got the job done, never taking no as an answer. The wild week one capped off with one of the sloppiest and slowest paced games I can ever remember. A game that featured 3 missed field goals by the Titans and god-awful clock management by the Broncos. It seemed to mercifully end for us all around 1:30 a.m. Eastern for all the faithful fans who definitely didn't regret staying up that late the next day. Oh well, weird week. On to week 2, baby. Let's keep this weird-ass season a-rollin'.